Breast augmentation is a popular plastic surgery operation designed to both increase the size of the breasts and also improve the shape. It's performed under general anesthetic and the majority of patients go home on the same day. During the operation, a small incision is made underneath the breast in the natural breast fold. The implant is inserted either above the muscle or just below the muscle. The incisions are closed with dissolving absorbable sutures and a simple tape is applied to the incision. There are many different shapes and sizes of breast implants, and the breast implant is matched to your goals for surgery, in other words, what sort of look you're hoping for, and also your natural anatomy. At the end of the operation, a support bra is used to support the breasts, but there are no other dressings and no drains. The patients often go home on the day of surgery, and I recommend that they take a week off work. Breast augmentation is a routine procedure, and the vast majority of patients come through without any problems whatsoever. However, there are some complications you need to be aware of, and these include general things such as infection or bleeding. These are actually very rare in breast augmentation surgery, occurring in about 1 in 100 patients, but may be a reason why you have to return to theater. There are complications relating to the implant. The implants we use nowadays are very durable and robust, but in a minority of cases, they may rupture or get scar tissue formation around them that deforms the breast. This is termed capsular contracture and is one of the more common reasons why patients undergo a revision. There are some things which are common to all patients. These include having some degree of nipple numbness or numbness of the skin around the breast. This usually improves over a period of 6 weeks to 6 months. There will also be swelling, and this takes several weeks and months to settle down. Another common issue is that the breast implants often sit quite high early on and they take some time to settle down into their natural position. This process is called fluff and drop. In a minority of patients, bleeding after the procedure may result in swelling in the breast pocket around the implant and require further operation to remove the blood clot. About 15% of patients who have breast augmentation surgery will have a revision within 10 to 15 years. The scar is very small, around 4 centimeters or so, and it's placed directly in the fold underneath the breast. Over time, the scar fades, and because of its location, becomes very inconspicuous. Pain is very subjective, and it varies from patient to patient. The majority of patients require regular painkillers for the first 4 or 5 days. By day 4 or 5, most patients are relatively pain-free, moving comfortably, and not requiring any further analgesia. The implants often sit high, and it takes time for them to settle into a more natural position. This process takes around 6 months. I usually recommend patients take a week off work, and it's 4 or 5 weeks before they can return to strenuous exercise, such as lifting weights, running, and swimming. This is a very common question and an important issue. I tell all my patients that they have to expect to have another operation at some stage in their life. However, if there are no issues with the implants and patients are pleased with the shape of their breasts, then there is no need for a revision or to have the surgery redone. Having said that, about 15 to 20% of patients will have a revision procedure within 10 to 15 years. The most common reason for this is scar tissue around the implant, which can deform the breast shape and make it hard. This is called capsular contracture. Another, but less common reason is that the implant may rupture. And sometimes patients just want a change in the size of their implant or a further breast reshaping procedure such as a lift.